You get Johnny Mathis for my high school reunion? I swear. I will never again publicly refer to you as Mr. Gunkface. Chances are...
See my softball glove?
Yeah, I know I did. I saw it here somewhere. No, I didn't. Oh. Well, I couldn't find the tongs.
I have got a game in a couple of minutes. It's going to be a little difficult to use this.
Can't you just be on the team that hits?
Ever since this high school reunion thing has come up, you have been on another planet. I mean, why don't you let who's ever running this thing put somebody else in charge of getting entertainment?
Oh, don't you realize that Little Miss Perfect, Sandy Martin, has asked everyone to do the same job for this reunion that they did for the senior prom, but I am the only one who had to fight her to get my old job back? Even Tommy Rygott, a convicted car thief, is still in charge of valet parking.
Oh, that's right. I remember that little prom mishap you had.
Little mishap? I told the band the wrong date. 300 kids with bad haircuts wound up dancing to the school's one scratched polka record.
Oh, come on, Madeline. It could happen to anyone.
Well, almost all the horrible things that happened to me in high school could have happened to anyone, but they all happened to me in front of everyone. The mail, did I get anything?
No.
No, I can't believe this. Not one response in 2 weeks. I must have written to every performer who was alive in 1963.
Okay, let me look. Oh, come on. You really don't think you're going to get Johnny Mathis to sing at the Julia Faraday High School reunion? I mean, hell, he's still a big star.
Obviously, he would be the dream. Happens to be in Chicago for a concert next week, but I know he would be very tough to get. What about Jimmy Gilmer and the Fireballs? I suppose they're too busy giving Carnegie Hall recitals of Sugar Shack to answer.
Anything from the singing nun?
Zippo. I think a nun would have written back.
Come on. What's that? It's a list of entertainers Madeline's trying to get for a reunion.
Hey, if you want Johnny Mathis, you could have asked me. He's a friend of mine. Come on, guy, we'll be late for the game.
Bob, how good a friend?
Well, the last time he was in town, there was a blizzard, and he had to make this concert in New York. So I bumped this snotty blonde who wouldn't go out with me, and I got him on the last flight out. Anyway, Johnny said, anytime I needed a favor, just let him know. Let's go.
Hey, Bob, now Bobby. Rob, if you get Johnny Mathis for my high school reunion, I swear, I will never again publicly refer to you as Mr. Gunkface.
It's a deal.
Okay, bye, Charlie.
Bye.
Bye, Mr. Gunkface. No, just a little incentive. That's all. Charlie, it's just the same. It's the gym that time forgot. Just smell it.
I think it's a law. They have to smell like this.
Charlie is standing on it.
What?
The very spot where Cheryl McKechnie fired a dodgeball at me gave me a bloody nose. Here I am. I'm staggering around. I'm bleeding. All here is, nice arm, Cheryl.
Dodgeball, I love that game. There was always one fat kid you just couldn't miss.
Now let's join the very pretty, intimidating, and extremely dismissive Faraday cheerleaders in a salute to Stuck Uppery.
Yeah! Did you ever try to be a cheerleader?
Yeah, once. Yeah. I think I was that bad, really. They said another redhead would throw off the color scheme. Several years later, as an adult, I came to question that.
I was never much a cheerleader. I always preferred attainable redheads.
Mm. You were probably pretty neat in high school, huh? Dash a nerd, but pretty popular, huh?
Well, I mean, I wasn't the big man on campus, but, yeah, I mean, I was pretty popular.
What? Dash a nerd.
Little nerd.
Yeah. Little. Let's get out of here.
Madeline! Returning to the scene of the crime.
Yeah. Sandy, this is my husband, Charlie. Charlie, this is Sandy Martin.
Oh.
He was the head cheerleader.
So, Madeline, you watching the entertainment rehearse?
Nobody there. Oh, yeah, I get it.
Well, let's forget about your little prom fiasco and talk about the reunion. Are you getting anybody good, or should I just ask, are you getting anybody?
Oh, well, I'm sure Madeline will come up with some good entertainment.
Well, whoever it is, I hope you gave him the right date this time.
I'm getting Johnny Mathis.
Madeline, I underestimated you. That's quite a coup. Well, I'll have to spread the word. See you and Johnny at the reunion.
I know.
You can just put that anywhere.
Oh. Guess you just had to do that, didn't you?
Mm-hmm. Do you realize that I have placed my entire future in the hands of gunk-faced Leone? If he doesn't come through, it's going to be prom night two. The nightmare continues. Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
Madeline, I spoke to Bob. He's still trying to get Johnny Mathis.
That's not going to happen. Some people are born for greatness. I was born to be humiliated every 20 years in front of the same 300 people.
Don't give up. I'm sure it'll work out. Bye-bye.
Who is it?
Chances are, 'cause I wear a silly grin.
There's a diseased mind at work here, son.
Come on, admit it, you were fooled.
Yes, I was fooled, at the same time staggered by the incredible pointlessness of whatever this is you're doing.
Look, I tried, but I couldn't get through to Johnny Mathis.
Gunk face.
It's not my fault that you were dumb enough to tell everybody that you could get Johnny Mathis before you knew for sure. And since I couldn't get past his manager, I got some guys from a celebrity impersonator service.
This guy looks nothing like Johnny Mathis.
Well, I was prompt.
Look, they're sending over other guys, some real good lookalikes.
Are we losing grip on reality here? I am one day away from a major trauma.